All right, definitely the space to be in this morning is metals. JSPL is up and about. Early morning, it posted steel production data for Q3 and recorded the highest ever quarterly domestic production of crude steel. As well, as I said, you know, all steel companies are in focus as the prices of hot rolled coils were hiked a little higher than expected, given the domestic steel price is a premium compared to imports. Now, VR Sharma, the MD of JSPL, joins us now to talk about all of these triggers. Mr. Sharma, good morning and thank you for joining us. I wanted to first start with the steel production data that you just released and the sales data as well, where there's a 30% rise that we've seen in this quarter. How is the situation on the ground now? Do you expect sales to pick up further? And what is the full year target that you have?
Yes, good morning and wish you all a very happy new year. The quarter three has been very good for JSPL. We have surpassed all the production figures and sales figures of the previous years. And as we have already declared the results, we could reach to a level of 30% growth in terms of sales. And production is 22%. Similarly, in Oman, we have done a sales growth of 27% and production growth of 10%. As far as the demand is concerned, because of the infrastructure growth in the country and a regular and a very relentlessly efforts by Government of India, the projects have started picking up. And we in JSPL, because we are in different product than the most of our peer group, we are getting benefit of that. And we feel that the market will continue as it is. And Q4 should be better than the Q3. And as far as the prices are concerned, we have already increased the prices by 1,500 rupees starting from yesterday. And the market has responded very well. And I'm sure that whatever the steel industry was in pressure and the prices were bottomed out, so those prices will come up and the steel industry will be back to the track.
So I just have two follow-up questions here. A, when you say demand is picking up, are you seeing more demand come through from private infrastructure or is it from the government end? And B, for the full year, what is your sales target?
You see, our sales target was 6.5 million ton. We'll surpass it. We hope that we'll cross 7 million ton. This is one from India. Mm-hmm. And from Oman, we had a target of 2 million ton. We'll achieve 2 million ton. So it'll be a company of about 9.5 million ton by the end of the year. Though our target was 6.5 plus 2, that was 8.5 million ton. As far as the demand is concerned, of late we have found demand coming from the building sector also, from the construction sector also. And the infrastructure growth from the government projects is phenomenal. So we are expecting that the government spending in infrastructure will continue and we will get good business.
Okay, that's very good news. I guess the year is off to a great start for you, Mr. Sharma. Season's greetings to you. I just want to get a little more granular on pricing. Now, what you told us is that you've undertaken a price hike of 1,500 rupees per ton from the 1st of Jan. Can you detail what products is it on, or is it an average blended price hike? And also, how much higher were Q3 prices? Because there were some price increases that you had undertaken even in November, I believe.
Yes, we have undertaken the price increase in Q3 also, that is in November and early December. This 1,500 rupees over and above the December prices. So this is one. The second is, except for the long-term contracts like rails, the prices have been increased in all the sectors, like be it rebars, be it plates, be it structurals, and TMT, and also the semis like billets. So the long-term contracts like with railway, so those prices will be discussed in the month of April 2020. And otherwise, everything has been in track.
And what was
so the price increase all across the product?
Okay, so the price increases all across. Now, for the Q3 price hike, what is the total quantum? If you could just tell us what's been the average increase in the third quarter, because that will have a direct impact on your Q3 profitability, of course.
Yeah, the third quarter we had an increase of 1,000 rupees per ton starting from December 1st, and over and above now 1,500 rupees from 1st of Jan. So total is 2,500 rupees per ton.
Okay, 2,500 rupees per ton. That's on prices, but can we move on and talk a little bit about what's happening with the Gare Palma coal block? Has it been cancelled by the government? Have you received any communication on that front? What's the latest there?
You see, the Gare Palma, it is an issue which government has to decide. But frankly speaking, we are not adversely affect because the Gare Palma is not with us. Because you must have seen that in last 2 to 3 weeks' time, the Coal India has ramped up their production. And we are sitting in the vicinity of the Coal India mines, and we are getting full quantity. So buying coal from Coal India today is much cheaper than mining the coal and taking it out. So I think God does everything good. So we are happy. There is no problem.
So let me just understand this fully, Mr. Sharma. Have you received an official communication that JSPL's bid has been disqualified? Is there any official communication on Gare Palma that you received from the government?
No, there is no declaration by government.
Okay, so nothing's actually come through so far. Speaking in terms of, ensuring your iron ore supplies, what about the case with Sarda, and when is the next hearing there, the Supreme Court case?
You see, I think in the second week of January, this case will be heard once again. And I'm sure we will get our reserves which are available. Already we have piled up stocks of millions of tons in the premises of Sarda mines. And we will get the possession of that material for sure.
Okay. Now let's talk about the financials a little bit. Because of this demand revival and the way prices are headed as well, what could we assume as an approximate EBITDA per ton for the next few quarters? I think in Q2 it was around 9,500 rupees per ton. Do you think you can do better than that in the coming quarters?
Yes, we will definitely. I think we'll cross 10,000 rupees per ton EBITDA, and we will do it. That is our aim, and
so
we'll do it.
So 10,000 is by when? I mean, is it going to be in the second half or in this quarter itself?
No, it is from today.
Okay.
Yeah, this quarter.
All right.
Q4.
Okay.
So, sir, on the whole, I remember at the end of the second quarter, it seemed that there was some pressure that was building up on the business, and input costs were climbing higher as well. It seems from everything that you're saying that the second half is turning out to be very, very robust. So, for the year as a whole, FY20, what should we expect on the profitability parameters?
You see, there's no doubt. The quarter first was fairly good, but quarter two was very bad. And part of quarter three, like especially month of October, it was also worst, I would say, for the entire steel industry. But November, we started looking up. We never compromised on the volumes, and whether it is production or sales, we could do whatever we could produce, we could sell. And now December was very favorable. Now, I think December, Jan, Feb and March, these 4 months will change the total scenario and the profitability will increase. We are expecting a EBITDA of about 700 crore rupees per month-on-month basis from Jan, Feb and March. So that will be 2,100 crore. Though in October, November, this was less. This was 420, 430 crores rupees. But there is an increase what we are expecting from Jan itself, that is 700 crore rupees per month.
Okay. Since we are at the start of a new decade, let's talk a little bit about the longer term projections as well, Mr. Sharma. On the steel business, if you look at the last 5 year growth trajectory, it's been remarkable. It's gone from 3 million tons, and now you say by the end of the fiscal it'll be at 9 million tons. So that's about a threefold jump there in the last 5-6 years. And power as well has gone from 1,000 megawatts to about 3,500 megawatts in the last 5 years. Over the next 2 to 3 years, both on the steel business for India and in the power business, what kind of projections would you have?
You see, we are not going to invest money in capex. We don't want to add any facility in the country, neither here nor in Oman. So we want to continue with our existing facilities. We want to optimize the production. We want to sweat out the assets. We want to reach to 9.5 million ton from India and another 2 million ton from Oman. So total will be about 11 million ton from both the locations. So 9 million ton or 9.5 million ton by all measures, it is a very large plant. So we will be crossing about 50,000 crores of turnover, which is fairly good when we rate to the Indian industry. There are not many companies, those who are crossing 50,000 crores of turnover in the country. That is sales turnover, I'm telling. We are aiming a very good EBITDA level, about 15,000 crores. And I'm sure by 2021, we'll be in a position to reach to 9.5 million ton from the existing setups. We don't need to expand plant. We don't need to bring more and more manufacturing facilities. We do not want to invest in capex. Our main aim is to become debt-free as early as possible. So that is the company's main aim.
That was actually my last question to you, sir. Because the chairman has been quoted as saying that you want to become debt-free in the next 4 years. So what are the near-term milestones? FY20, by the time we end this financial year, how much debt would you have repaid? And by how much can we expect the finance cost to start coming down?
You see, our aim was, we have taken in early April 2019, the aim to reduce the debt from 40,000 crore rupees to 34,000 crore. And we'll achieve this 34,000 crore level. The next year again, we are planning about 7,000 crore rupees debt reduction. So that will be 27,000 crore. So if we keep on doing reduction by 7,000 crore rupees per year, then in 3 years' time, we reach to a level about 15,000 to 17,000 crore rupees, which is too meager amount when we compare with the turnover about 50,000 crores. And when we compare and we benchmark it 9.5 million ton capacity. So that is our aim.
Okay, all right. Well, all the best. And your stock has given a lot of rewards to investors and created a lot of wealth. Hope you continue to do that for yourself and for your shareholders. Thanks so much for joining us. So that's JSPL. Had a huge growth if you map the last 5 years. As I was saying, from FY14, the steel production has gone from 3 million tons. And he just said that by the end of FY20, they'll be at 9 million tons. So that's a threefold increase in over 5 years. But let's look at the numbers posted by JSPL in the past three financial years. First up, the sales trend been remarkable there. Next up is the company's EBITDA performance. That as well has grown quite well. And lastly, it's a net loss company. So the loss posted by JSPL in the recent past has actually gone up quite a bit. So sitting at losses of 2,400 crores as on FY19.